While we've seen many sci-fi movies where humans are able to fly using personal kits, things are moving from real to real. The British Royal Marines recently experimented with a jetpack that can reach speeds of 80 miles per hour, or about 130 kilometers per hour, and climb to 12,000 feet. The jetpack, named Daedalus, is designed and built by Richard Browning, a former Royal Marine reservist and Gravity Industries founder and chief test pilot. The jetpack was used recently for demonstration, as part of which test pilots flew from a small military raft to a ship on open water. One look at the footage, it will be clear that the system has a lot of potential. In this video, Defense Updates analyzes how Gravity Industries' jetpack could change the way British Royal Marines fight future wars. Let's get started. This video is sponsored by the free-to-play military vehicle combat game War Thunder. We talk a lot about military vehicles on this channel, but what about trying them out for yourself? In War Thunder, you can choose from more than 1,200 playable vehicles from the 1930s to the 1990s and go to battle on more than 80 theaters of war. You can fly aircraft, helicopters, drive tanks, and command ships of all types and sizes, which have been carefully recreated from their real-world counterparts. It's available as a free download on PC, PlayStation 4, and Xbox One with cross-platform support, so grab your friends and give it a try. All viewers of Defense Updates that register using the link in the description below will also get a free premium tank, aircraft, or ship, and 3 days of premium account time as a bonus. The 42-year-old Richard Browning said it's the ride of his life. "It's just like riding a bike, so easy when you get the hang of it." He added, "Honestly, there's no effort. It works by thrust. When you bring your arms down, you go up, and you flare your arms out to come down. It's that simple." Gravity Industries wrote on YouTube after its successful demonstration of its jet suit, "The footage speaks for itself." The company said in a news release, "The vision with the jet suit is to provide extremely rapid access of any part of the target vessel, instantly freeing up hands to bear a weapon, and even retaining the capability to relocate on target or self-exfiltrate. This is increasingly seen as a revolution in tactical capability for many special forces and has much broader application beyond maritime boarding." The UK's Royal Marines are exploring a wide range of technologies to boost their combat effectiveness. The Daedalus jetpack is one of the most notable ones and is capable of achieving flight, hovering, and powered jumps. Richard Browning first started work on the project in the year 2016. The suit's been likened to the comic character Iron Man. Browning formed his own company, Gravity, and used his own funding for development work. The first published test flight was revealed at the 2017 TED conference in Vancouver. Browning experimented with different numbers, configurations, and arrays of jets, with varying degrees of success, before coming up with his current configuration. The 1,000 horsepower backpack system can carry one person aloft for up to 10 minutes at a time. The system uses 6 micro gas turbines. The flight pack can reach altitudes of 2,000 feet, though its envisaged normal use would be traveling at only 3 or 4 meters above the ground. The flight pack incorporates a heads-up display that presents the user with operational information, including top speed, fuel left, etc. The system costs around $400,000. The Daedalus flight pack broke a record for speed for a flight pack awarded by the Guinness Book of Records. The current way for boarding and capturing ships is to use small boats and ladders to have operators rappel down from helicopters, but that takes time and often exposes the Marines to enemy fire. This is one scenario where the Daedalus jetpack could come in very handy. The footage shows 3 versions of an underway boarding exercise. In the first, the jet-jumping marine operator launches from the front of the rubber craft and quickly heads to the side of the ship's bridge, where he lands and then throws over a ladder for his teammates to move in. In the second boarding exercise, the jetpack operator uses the same move but also takes off a second time once again to land on the helicopter landing pad on the aft section of the ship. In the third demonstration, there are three jetpack operators coming in for a landing in the same spot. The idea in this case is to use shock and overwhelming force. In all the cases, the jetpack allowed Marines to move much more swiftly to board the target craft than possible through traditional methods. There are a lot of potential uses, like replenishment operations, rescue scenarios. This is not the first time a demonstration such as this has been undertaken. Gravity pulled off a similar drill in the English Channel in 2019. Browning personally strapped on the jetpack and showed how he could easily fly through the air and land on a moving ship. The idea is surely cool, but it's yet to move into the practical realm. This will take time. The runtime of 10 minutes is a major limitation and hopefully will improve as Gravity Industries keeps working on enhancements. After the recent demonstration, Browning said in the future, the suit could be used in combat. You probably wouldn't need helicopters or a lot of infantry. The possible operational deployment is currently being kept secret. He stated, "The military world and the military see it as something that can be used in active operations. I've been involved in some pretty weird training ops, but I can't say too much about all that." It remains to be seen how things pan out in the coming days. Thanks for watching. Subscribe for more videos like this. Hit the like button if you find the video interesting, and kindly provide your feedback in the comment section. This will help us improve.